Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Horror Mine. My name is Vic Shy, and this is The Scare Score, where I break down horror movies and rate them on how scary I think they are. In this episode, I'll be going over the 2011 South Korean horror film, White, Melody of Death. The film tells the story of a K-pop girl group trying their best to make it in the competitive industry. They discover an old VHS tape containing an old undiscovered song and a complimentary curse to go along with it. I'll be going over the events that take place throughout the film while our scare score goes up or down based on how effective the scares are or attempt to be. A horror film based on the lives of a K-pop girl group is an interesting concept to say the least, and more disturbing than you may think. But how scary is it? Sit back and relax and join me as we explore White, Melody of Death, and tally up the scare score. Our movie begins with a generic yet effectively creepy intro that sets the tone for this horror-filled K-pop world. We transition right into a lively competition between several K-pop groups, the best of them being a group called Pure, who continuously top the number one popularity charts. But of course, our main characters are not Pure, but a group called Pink Dolls that fall way lower on the popularity list. The group consists of Arang, vocalist Jenny, rapper Sinji, and team leader Eunju. After boring the audience out of their minds, Pink Dolls sit in envy backstage as Pure once again wins the number one spot. Eunju is the oldest and most optimistic of the group that doesn't seem to get along very well. The group blames their agency for their lack of exposure, but their manager reminds them that they are responsible for their own success. The Dolls move into a newly renovated studio that was bought out, most likely for cheap, after a fire occurred there years ago. While cleaning the mirrors in the dance room, Eunju discovers an old VHS titled White, though I'm much more interested in the one titled Hot Slide Live. She plays the old VHS tape, which if you're a regular on the channel, know is never a good idea. The heavily distorted and staticky footage is of an unknown dance group performing a song. The footage is actually quite disturbing, and the song, although catchy, has a certain level of creepiness to it. The manager walks in and Eunju pauses the video on a disturbing frame. The manager says that the studio belonged to the father of their sponsor named Choi. Sponsor Choi's father passed away in the fire that occurred in the studio 15 years ago. The footage plays again on its own and catches the manager's attention. The sound editor tells her that the song has no owner and she tells him to adapt the song for the Pink Dolls, a decision that we all know is going to lead to deadly consequences. The dance choreographer works out a dance similar to the original, but the group doesn't seem too enthusiastic about it. They begin to bicker amongst themselves and bring up Eunju's past of being a backup dancer. Sinji is the edgy member of the group and says that when she dances, she imagines being crushed to death by the fans. Eunju meets with her best friend and vocalist Soonyi at one of my favorite places to hang out, a karaoke lounge. The best friends are both considered older within the industry and promise to become a duo if Pink Dolls' latest song doesn't work out. The group get ready to perform their new song called White at a showcase. We see the abusive side of the manager who smacks Sinji for requesting to cancel their appearance. The Dolls are extremely nervous prior to their performance and it's up to team leader Eunju to motivate them. She says that she is going to perform like it's her final performance. This motivates the young girls more than when SpongeBob banded the losers on the beach to perform the Ripped Pants song. No, I shouldn't mope around, I shouldn't curse, but the pain feels so much worse. Pink Dolls go out and absolutely crush it, becoming an overnight sensation. Sort of like when my video on Squid Games went viral and my channel proceeded to never replicate those same results. As the group's success and popularity rises due to the song, so does the pressure. The manager tells them that they must top the charts of a show called Music Fever, which by the looks on their faces, must be very hard to do. She also tells them that the group will now have a center member as opposed to evenly splitting the parts. This creates more tension among the already divided group. While looking for an outfit, a spirit with white hair is standing directly behind Jenny.
Ya, 메인도 아닌데 누가 먼저 쓰래?
She is now terrified and her reaction definitely enhances the scare. This was a subtle and creepy scene that is scarier knowing the ghost was behind her the entire time. The girls do a photo shoot with a white wig to see who looks like the best center. Jenny gets chosen as the center but appears uncomfortable rather than happy. She expresses concern for the high note she must sing. While recording the song, Jenny seems terrified of something and is drinking an unusual amount of tonics. She asks if anyone is doubling the song as she feels someone is singing along with her. She apologizes to Eunju for what happened before and says that it's hot in here. We see ghostly hands being wrapped around her neck before she hits that sweet high note. The group return to the studio and the fans are going absolutely wild. Eunju goes looking for Jenny, who has been recording the entire day. She walks down the dark hallway as we hear Jenny singing the high note from the recording room. This gave me genuine chills. She walks into the room and Jenny's singing now sounds more like a terrified squeal. Jenny spins around, revealing that the microphone cord is wrapped around her neck. She begins screeching and vomits all over the glass. Eunju watches helplessly as Jenny hangs from the cord. We hear a woman humming over the speaker and see the white-haired ghost clinging onto Jenny's body through the reflection. This was an exceptionally well-done scare scene. It started out as mildly creepy and gradually got scarier and more disturbing as the scene went on. This is when I knew I was in for a good one. Jenny is hospitalized following the incident, which is blamed on hallucinations from the tonics she took. The rest of the group attend a fan event where one dude seems like he's been waiting his entire life for this moment. Arang believes that someone sabotaged Jenny by putting a little something-something in her tonics. Eunju goes back into the recording room that still hasn't been cleaned up and treats us to a pretty neat jump scare courtesy of accidental playback. She opens an online bulletin board for fans of the group showing a distorted video of Jenny. She believes there may be something strange about the song White. An embarrassing picture leaks on the internet of Sinji being an understudy for Pure. Sinji confronts Arang for posting it and the two get physical before Eunju steps in. Arang admits to posting the photo and has these weird bandages over her eyes as she just had surgery. She said she posted the photo because she believes Sinji added chemicals to all her cosmetics. She puts on the white wig and begins applying makeup, which sort of reminded me of Joker. As she is applying the cosmetics, a generic scare attempt walks behind the glass. The person behind the glass is mimicking Eunju's voice and says that White belongs to her. She looks behind the glass to see that no one's there. She turns back around to see blood on her face and all her cosmetic bottles filled with blood. The table starts shaking on its own but eventually stops and things return to normal. She tries crawling away but some nasty old feet foil her escape plan. She cries in horror, but we don't see what she sees. This was a decently scary scene. Not as scary as Jenny's attack, but creepy in its own right. Arang is now the main, but is traumatized after her ghostly encounter. Before she goes on, she tells Eunju that it's hot in here, just like Jenny. She shoots a music video where she has to spin around and gets a little dizzy. Her eyes begin to ooze as ghostly hands slowly poke out of her hair and squeeze her eyes. The equipment tips over, causing Arang to be thrown off stage. She is taken to the hospital and just like that, two members of the group remain. Eunju and Sinji get into a dance battle to show everyone who deserves the main spot. The dance battle gets heated, competitive, and a little disturbing. Someone may want to call an exorcist. Eunju goes back onto the bulletin board and now sees a distorted video of Arang. She writes down the words combined from both clips that read, "It's so hot." She shows her findings to Sun Yi before a fake out jump scare. Sinji is now looking edgier than ever and confronts her remaining main spot competitor. She goes into the dance room to practice her moves in front of the mirrors, but one reflection is eerily moving different than the others. This scare, just like her moves, is on point. It's created perfectly using sound design and subtle imagery. She realizes something isn't quite right and the lights begin to dim. She looks at her reflection and sees her evil multiverse variant staring back at her. In a very cool scene, her reflection begins laughing at her. They disappear one by one as the white ghost swiftly approaches her before busting out a jump scare. Eunju and Sunyi do more research into the fire that happened 15 years ago which killed 10 people, including a young singer named Zhang Yibin who was the main singer of White. A trainee also took her own life by drinking poison prior to the fire. They quickly realize that the song White is actually cursed and that the mains of the song are possibly being targeted by the spirit of Zhang Yibin. Sinji is now the main and is chosen to appear on a show called Survival Challenge where she must escape the building and avoid being caught. She goes searching for the exit while also being stalked by the white ghost. Nothing too scary happens here aside from the occasional quickly disappearing ghost cliche. She runs out of the building and is met by a barrage of crazy fans. They bump into the camera equipment, causing it to latch onto Sinji by the hair and lift her in the air. Her spinning around and screaming for her life must be the coolest thing they've ever seen as they take pictures of it. The white ghost appears above her and she is crushed by the equipment. She sustains a spinal fracture, but the manager assures everyone that she's fine and just a little hurt. Eunju is convinced that she is next and wants to unravel the origin of the curse. After some video editing to the original song, they isolate a part where a voice eerily says, "There's no face." Zhang Yibin's face also appears damaged on the video, which they attribute to possible sabotage from jealous team members. Not everything is adding up just yet. Eunju is now in Zhang Yibin's exact position and feels like history is repeating itself. She has a meeting with sponsor Choi and asks him about the incident from 15 years ago. He mentions a talented trainee who wrote her own songs and choreographed her own moves but doesn't mention Zhang Yibin by name. He says that the trainee's face got injured and that she lost the main spot. She took her own life soon after, revealing that she was not a victim of the fire. Sponsor Choi unbuttons his shirt and Eunju tragically gives up her body to secure the main spot, which I didn't see as absolutely necessary considering she was the only one left in the group. She returns to the studio defeated and is shown flashbacks of what happened to the trainee with white hair. The trainee was taken advantage of by the sponsor and attacked by her fellow members out of jealousy. They disfigured her face and she took her own life, becoming a vengeful spirit as a result. She discovers the letter written by the trainee prior to taking her own life underneath the floorboards. The letter reads, "They stole my song, they hurt my face, and it's so hot." However, it's partially burned and the entire contents of the letter remains a mystery, just like the one my father wrote me 20 years ago. They hold a memorial for Zhang Yibin and place the tape next to her picture, hoping it will put her spirit to rest. Psych! There's 30 minutes left in the film. Eunju is now a solo artist and is being rebranded as White. That's cool, I guess. You've just discovered there's a curse that originated from a stolen song, and now you're proceeding to steal said song and make your debut anyways. She goes all in by dyeing her hair white and looks exactly like 2B. White has been beating Pure on the music charts and is going head-to-head with them on the 200th episode of Music Fever. Meanwhile, her former groupmates are all seeing her solo success from their cozy hospital beds. While signing CD covers, she writes a special message to an unknown person. She steals Sinji's quote and tells her backup dancers that when she dances, she imagines getting crushed to death by the fans. She does an interview and dismisses her best friend as just an acquaintance, showing that the fame is getting to her head. She claims to have written the song herself and that she was never a backup dancer. Her former groupmates are now announcers on a TV show and look absolutely miserable. They accuse Eunju of sabotaging them and fabricating Zhang Yibin's story so she could become the main. Sunyi listens to the original song one more time and realizes that there was a double singing the entire time, not Zhang Yibin. The studio suddenly receives a call telling them that Jenny, Arang, and Sinji have all taken their own lives by drinking bleach live on air. The sight is pretty disturbing and shows just how much pressure and trauma they've experienced trying to make it in the industry. Sunyi calls Eunju to tell her the curse isn't over, but she refuses to listen and says that she is White now.
Welcome to the club.
After messing around with the original video, they detach an audio file that says here, behind you. They see that there was a ghost dancing behind Zhang Yibin in the video the entire time. They discover that White actually belonged to the trainee who took her own life. Right before she goes on, the stage manager calls for the 8 backup dancers to take their place. However, Eunju is convinced that there were 9 total backup dancers. She now sees a video of herself on the bulletin board and tries deleting it, realizing that the curse is still active. The time has finally come for White and Pure to go head-to-head in the popularity polls. Eunju is clearly distracted and worried about the curse. Sunyi makes it into the building relatively easy considering all the security guards trying to block the crazy fans. White defeats Pure in the popularity polls and gets to perform her song in front of the whole world. During the performance, she is surrounded by backup dancers and sees the white ghost among them. The lights suddenly go out and fall onto the stage, causing sparks to fly all around. Sponsor Choi tries to save Eunju but is knocked in the head by a falling light and killed. Complete chaos ensues and the audience frantically tries to escape the building. The manager also tries saving her but is burned by the pyrotechnics. The white ghost appears in front of her and creepily crawls towards her. The only scary thing about this scene was how the ghost was crawling. Everything else involving the flashing lights and several cuts was pretty annoying. It appears that the white ghost apologizes to Eunju, possibly meaning that she has no control over her rage and the curse. Sunyi enters the auditorium and does a good job of walking against the flow of a frantic crowd. The same can't be said for Eunju, whom instead of staying on stage, makes her way into the crowd to try and escape. This tragically results in her being brutally trampled to death by her fans, something that was foreshadowed by what she said earlier in the film. Seeing Eunju get trampled to death is absolutely brutal and the noises she makes are disturbing. The white ghost appears on stage viewing the chaos and carnage that was caused as a result of her curse. We then see a flashback showing what truly started the curse. White belonged to an unnamed trainee who wrote the song and choreographed the dance. She obtained the main spot by sleeping with Sponsor Choi Sr. Zhang Yibin was a jealous team member that stole the song and damaged White's face. White took her own life by drinking bleach as a result of the abuse she endured at the hands of her own groupmates. This is why the phrase "it's hot in here" is associated with the curse, as bleach burned her insides. Zhang Yibin became the main but became paranoid that White's spirit was always behind her, which proved to be true when she reviewed the video. Zhang Yibin tried to burn White's letter that detailed what happened to her but got spooked by her spirit, which started the studio fire that killed her and 9 others. The moral of the story? Don't steal other people's content. And don't be a dick. In the film's final scene, Sunyi returns to the karaoke lounge she frequented with Eunju. She burned White's letter along with the CD given to her by her best friend with the special message. The smoke detectors go off and she hears a woman's voice humming. The screen shows the song White is about to be played, revealing the curse isn't over as the movie ends. And that, ladies and gentlemen, was White, Melody of Death. My friends, this was a very solid horror flick. The premise had me a little worried as to what exactly I was getting myself into. The plot was pretty standard and a little generic. However, the film was filled with cleverly presented scares and some genuinely disturbing scenes. It also has its fair share of jump scares, earning White's Melody of Death a good scare score of 65%. The scariest scene in the film was Jenny's attack. The film perfectly sets up the scare scene as Eunju walks towards the recording room as Jenny's screams fill the hallway. Her screams on the recording are absolutely disturbing and made for a brilliant scare that set the tone for the rest of the film. But as always, I hope you all enjoy the video. Thank you all for tuning in, and I cannot wait to see y'all right back here in the Horror Mine. Y'all stick around.